it's Lou Star, and this is my brand new controller that I just got yesterday. You probably don't really care about this. You can like skip ahead if you want, but I was at Largo. I took the metro there because I live in Arlington. It was like the last stop in the blue line. I was so far away. But that's where I got this controller. I got it at it wasn't a Best Buy. It was like some kind of like Best Buy. I think it was called an HH Gregg. But yeah, I went over there to that little mall and yeah, got the controller. So and today I'm just gonna be talking about it. I'm also gonna be comparing this controller and the original normal Xbox controller. Okay. So first off, let me start out with apologizing for kind of like the bad audio footages, but I want to get a camera for my birthday, something that I can actually like, it's actually a better recording, or I can probably re-record this when I get a camera, but this brings closer. So here we have, we're starting it off with these buttons right here. Yeah, those are just a regular Y, B, A, and X. But they're flat, so I guess it's easier to press. And these are also kind of flat, the back and start buttons. So you can press those easier. And here's a main Xbox button where you control it. And this is kind of hard to exactly fit in my hand. It's, I guess this is like mostly meant for like teenagers or something, but yeah. But you hold like this. But, it's not it. I do want to discuss how you hold it in the back also, because, believe it or not, there's actually a certain way you hold it in the back. But, here's the analog sticks. They're a bit more accurate. And here, let's compare right now. What I talked about earlier. See how, these buttons right here? See how they're flat? No. Unlike these original Xbox buttons are round, so yeah, but this one I can hold better in my hand. But anyways, not getting distracted. And again, this and this, compare it with this brand new modern thingy. Okay, so these have lights that glow. That's really, really cool, and they're a lot bigger. And okay. Notice right here. No, I didn't need a good angle. Come on. Okay, so right here, these two triggers, this RT and LT, well, they're kind of more flat, unlike these ones. Good angle. These ones go up a bit more. So you can kind of compare here. Let's bring both here. Do you kind of see the difference? These ones go up and these ones kind of stay. So that's more comfortable because, first off, you don't exactly need to worry about your finger exactly falling off when you're playing. And you also don't need to worry about, it's just a bit more accurate. You feel more precise when firing. And plus, I think when I opened this, or like the box or something, it gave a bit of an advertisement. I don't know if it's even on this remote, but it gave a bit of an advertisement saying, what am I trying to say nowadays? But, it gave a bit of an advertisement, and it said that it's just for quick firing. So I just tapped this really awesome, like really, really, really fast. And here, that's how you do the fast tapping. But yeah, it feels really precise. Yeah, it doesn't really have anything to do with it, but if you're wondering how it'll be like have a crazy finger at tapping, my brother said that you need a not exactly push this all the way down like this. You need to like push it halfway down. It's as far down as the controller or Xbox can detect it. So anyways, that's how you move fast. But so I already talked about this. Okay, front part is over. Now here's something new. Okay. Notice here, do you notice these new buttons right here? They're called Combat 8, no, not Combat, Combat 1 and Combat 2. Now, like this doesn't have any combat buttons. But yeah, this is one of the reasons why this is a plug-in controller, so they can have room for these combat buttons. Sorry. And so you can feel precise when you're playing. But yeah, these combat buttons here, you can edit them by switching these around, these little triggers. See? Yeah, you can edit, you can like change the controller, and what this does is like what the button you usually press does, you're gonna switch this to that button, and when you press this combat, it'll do that. For example, like right now I'm on Y. I know that if you're like playing, I play Black Ops or Modern Warfare 2, but if you usually press Y, it's to switch weapons. So since this is on Y, you can switch weapons by just easily pressing combat 1. That's all, that way you don't need to kind of delay it and move your thumb all the way up here to press it. So excuse me. And yeah. I don't exactly understand what this is for yet. This stands for. I don't know, it's probably one of the like analog buttons, but anyways, back to topic. I'd keep this on X and either this on A or B, because usually I'm really bad at jump shotting, or like prone shotting, or I forgot what it was called, but I'm not gonna try to remember, but yeah, it's a lot more easier because you can just keep playing, and then when like say an enemy's coming up to you, you can just quickly aim, go into prone, shoot, let go, run away. Easy as that, and then you reload, and you don't even need to worry. But okay, here. Time, let me give you an example. So you run, enemy's shooting you, aim, duck, team, prince in this button right here, the combat, and then you aim, and then you get back up really quickly. It's really simple, plus you also can reload pressing this analog stick right here. See it? Okay. So, one last thing I want to cover about the difference between this and this is, well, like I said earlier, it is a plug-in controller, but these wires are like, they're like rope. And I didn't really understand this. One of my theories is that it's because you need room for these combat buttons. But I saw another video that said it had something to do with these easy analog sticks to run around. Oh, let me discuss about that real quick. These analog sticks, I think they move slightly slower. They're like less precise. And like these are like accuracy. It's like the accuracy is increased. But yeah, you can, they're like ropes, and they go all the way down here. And keep in mind that say you like want to play split screen with somebody, and you need to plug this controller in. Keep in mind that let's unplug this part real fast. That you'll notice this part, it did not fit in any Xbox thing. This is one where you need to attach this on, and that was kind of tricky for me at first. It was really tricky. I was like, oh my gosh, I wasted $39 and I can't. Sorry for the crappy ending, but regardless, I was so freaked out because I thought it messed up and couldn't do anything with my controller. But keep in mind that you have to attach another wire to plug it into your Xbox. So anyway, that's it. Comment, rate, and subscribe, because this controller would be recommended to all like gaming. And also the comment buttons on the back, can't forget those. I'll be coming out with an Antagony Alpha soon, but this video is out of time, so I'll talk to you all later, and take care.